question is that the motion be agreed to.
Madam Speaker.
I call the Honourable Ian Lees-Galloway.
Thank you very much, Madam Speaker. Can I start my contribution by acknowledging the sponsor of this bill, Parmjeet Parmar, and the good intentions with which she brings this bill before the House. I think all members of this House want to see greater investment in research and development in New Zealand. We do lag behind other OECD nations on our private and public investment in research and development, and we want to see more businesses engaged in research, engaged in high technology activities, because we know that is what can help drive productivity, that is what can help drive wages up, that is what can improve living standards. And as a government that is absolutely focused on transitioning our economy to one that is productive, sustainable and inclusive, we certainly commend the member for bringing this bill to the House with those intentions. Which makes me wonder why the previous government didn't include a second-tier patent system when they introduced the new Patents Act in 2013. By 2013, plenty of other countries, as the member sponsoring the bill said, by 2013, many other countries had already had a two-tier system. It was not a new idea. And if it was a good idea, if it was one that was working well and that would be fit for purpose here in New Zealand, I'm quite sure that the previous government would have introduced it as part of its government legislation. That was legislation that the Labour Party and opposition supported. It was a good piece of legislation. And the idea that is at the heart of this bill that the member is bringing is one that could easily have been included in that bill. But I think there are good reasons why the previous government did not have a two-tier patent system as part of the Patents Act 2013. The first is that that there are question marks about whether two-tier systems really work. And in fact, many of the nations that have two-tier systems either have decided to do away with it or are actively considering whether they should do away with having a two-tier system. So, for instance, the Netherlands introduced a two-tier system in April 1995, but in June 2008, they did away with the two-tier system. As is common in most second-tier patent systems, there was no examination for novelty and inventive step at the Patent Office, and the unexamined six-year patents created legal uncertainty to competitors. Belgium followed in the Netherlands in January 2009, and the member raised Australia. Australia is another jurisdiction where they are seriously considering, actively considering, doing away with two-tier systems. So the members opposite are saying, well, send it to select committee. Well, actually, people have had their say in New Zealand, first of all, by not clamouring for this. We in the government actually tried to find where is the public outcry, where is the outcry from within the tech sector, where are the SMEs who want to engage in more research and development and want to actually be more high technology and to be able to get patents more easily. Where is the cry from them for this change? There isn't one. It's not there. It simply doesn't exist. In fact, Computer World New Zealand described this bill as something of a horror film for our industry. Now, I think that's a bit rough on the member, to be honest, but it does demonstrate the actual feelings of people out there who are actually operating in this space and if they thought this was a good idea, would be coming out and supporting it. I just want to quickly, I know I haven't got much time left for this evening, but I just want to touch on what the European Policy for Intellectual Property 10th Annual Conference comment that was made at that. As a conclusion, the empirical evidence on the economic benefits of two-tiered patent systems in advanced economies remains non-existent. Why would we, at this time, introduce a bill that takes us down a path that so many other countries are rejecting at this stage. I do appreciate what the member is trying to do. I understand the sentiment behind this bill, but it is clear that this is not the direction that other nations that we compare ourselves with is going in. In fact, they're going in the opposite direction.
Sorry to interrupt the member, but the time has come for me to leave the chair. The House stands adjourned until 2 p.m. tomorrow.